First question to the producer. This is a quite ambitious project. How this first film got made?
So there are actually many things as the director mentioned in the beginning. There are actually financial problems, weather problems, and then resources problems, and lots of problems are coming and facing. And we basically are dealing with problems every day. So the good side is that most of us are friends, most of the productions are friends, so we kind of work together and conquer the difficulties. Yeah.
How much is there state financing that the city government, local distribution or even district provides to make especially a first film?
就作为第一部那个长篇电影，就是国家和那个区域或者说是有其他帮助都来自哪里，而且这些帮助有多少，而且资金大概是多少，有数吗？
大概200万人民币，帮助。 接下来会有国家，会有团体，会有公司不同的这个组织，对，会有一些帮助。So
far we've worked ourselves around 2 million RMB to make the making of this film. The state helps and the other helpings may come afterwards the festival. So yeah.
How much do young filmmakers use Kickstarter or Indiegogo? Do you have something similar? Will you? Is that something hard or have you thought as a producer that you might use this platform?
就是他说中国有这种平台吗？你有想过用这种平台吗？以后会不会用到这种平台？
应该会有机会会用到，有一些创投会啊，有一些这个比较大的电影公司举办的这种创投会，还有电影节，但是您说的线上这种什么 Indiegogo 那些还没有，有众筹，对，有众筹网，可能类似于这样。就是你可以放了。
We actually don't have that much Indiegogo going on in China. There's also one, but they're more for commercial purposes. And also, going to some like industry forums and stuff to get monies from. And then for Indiegogo, maybe in the future, but not now. And the reason we're not using Indiegogo and Kickstarter for this project is because also the content of the film is more about himself. So, yeah.
Maybe we go with you. You chose the protagonist to be a quite young 11-year-old boy. And I know this is for very personal reasons. You could have chosen also any kind of older protagonist, but you wanted it to be the small boy. Why?
就是你选择为什么选择小孩，而且为什么是这个时期？就是因为影片里面我想说的事儿，它就是在一个孩子身上发生的事儿，就是这个孩子可以有一些我自己在这个年龄时候的影子。 所以就 选择了他.
Because the story happens in his childhood, and he wanted to show that time period. So at that time period, he's a boy. So he chose a boy to be his protagonist.
The film feels very much like a dream, like a tribute to nostalgia. It has a very beautiful atmosphere. How much of this is luck, and how much of this is really planning? Did you see the film like this from the very beginning?
他说你的电影其实非常梦幻，像梦境一样。然后有些是不知道哪些是真实的，还是哪些是运气。你一开始就这么计划的吗？还是有些其实是就是后期才形成的？
就谢谢您，那个认觉得这个电影里面还有一些梦幻。像梦一样，就是我想要创作这部电影的原因，也是因为我至今，就作为我现在来讲，我都没有很难分清这些东西哪些是真实的，或者哪些是像梦一样的，就是这个魅力，一直牵引我，然后把这个电影来完成了，嗯。
Thank you for feeling that it's more like a dream. And then because most of the film comes from his memory, so he couldn't actually recognize which part are reality, which part are dreaming. So yeah, that's the content of the film. 后面好讲吗？
而且就是好多电影导演他在拍第一个片子的时候，会多少和自己的经历有关系。然后这个经历其实就是记忆，而且记忆最有魅力的地方就是分不清真或假，看似很近，但是仔细想起来又会觉得很远，这个特别有魅力。
For most of the first features, for most young directors, they're mostly about their own story about themselves. So when they film about their memories, we couldn't actually tell memories are true or false, or they're close or far. Sometimes the dreams, the lives, they seem close because they're memories, but sometimes you couldn't remember them, or they're kind of far away and you never experienced before. 你好，说。
没了
you're in the cinematography of the film, you've chosen always a little bit of distance, and very rarely you go very close. Is that something that you planned beforehand?
他说你的镜头其实是都是中景和全景为主，然后这是你计划中的吗？而且你为什么会做这样的决定？
对，这个是我就是我们的电影美学就是这个样子的。可能我不想去太多的去参与到剧情里面，我更想躲在一旁，就像一个小孩一样，就躲在一旁，不跟他们任何人交流，然后就单纯的看。我觉得这样的一个试点会很有意思啊。
So the reason he chose mostly a medium shots and far and full shots and from a distance is because when it's his childhood memory. So when as a child he watched from a distance, so he doesn't want to participate into the adult events and don't want to participate to the adult the plot itself. So he just want to watch and then to just look at the adult.
你好，说
没有了。
来，各位。Last question.Now your film is about to play. Do you have some recommendation, some greeting note, something to the audiences who are coming to the screening?
就是你电影快要放了，然后明天晚上就放。你对观众和对其他人有什么想说的话吗？
就是希望大家喜欢。因为这个电影，不敢说它有多好，但它确实是投入了我或者是我身边所有朋友的情感来完成的。就冲这一点，它已经很有价值了。然后接下来就是希望能像我想的一样，有很多共同的东西能够让观众接受到。
Yes, first of all, we really want the Estonian audience to enjoy the film in the first place. And then because we put a lot of efforts in it, so no matter it is, what outcome it will come, we'll still value our efforts. So we really like that. So, and then we want the Estonian audience also to feel that. 最后一个你说了什么？
那就还是希望那个这种感觉也能够让。
Oh, and also he wants the feelings from the film and then to project to every individual lives, yes.
And last but not least, how has been Tallinn? It's freezing, it's cold, there's no sunlight, it looks like Mordor. How, do you enjoy it here? Or a little bit too cold?
他说这里冷，然后没什么阳光，然后很阴郁，然后很没什么感觉。你怎么喜欢？
一点都没有。
Yeah, he likes the city.
Yeah.
Now he don't feel like a cold and then stuff. He likes the place.
对对，就是外面越冷，就是这个会有对比。外面越冷，进到屋子里面有光有人的时候，就会觉得特别温暖，特别浪漫啊。
He says, because it's cold outside, so whenever you go inside, it's warm, and then you feel the people, and you feel the heat, so you feel more happy when you go inside and meet with people.
In Estonia, we drink a lot of alcohol because it's dark and very cold. Have you started more drinking here alcohol?
Yeah.
Yeah. 对，因为我们的故乡也很冷，而且那个就是越冷的地方，感觉心里越热，尤其是喝完酒之后啊。
It says, we drink a lot, of course, and we are also very good drinkers, and we don't behave well, especially after drinking. But and then at the same time, because he's from Inner Mongolia, and then the place also drink a lot, so he really liked the feeling that it's cold outside, so whenever you go inside, you drink and you meet with people, that feels good.
Let's drink beer.